good people of River State. 2 days ago, I addressed you on measures we have taken as a state to ensure that the coronavirus is prevented from entering our dear state. In that broadcast, I announced the setting up of surveillance posts at our land and sea borders beginning from Tuesday, March 24th, 2020. I also informed you that after due consultation with religious leaders, all forms of open worship, including crusades and vigils, were banned. Public burials and weddings were prohibited, while public parks, nightclubs, and cinemas were directed to close down. You will also recall that I said that we shall continue to review the situation and adjust accordingly. It is with gratitude to God that I announce to you that our state would have been infected with coronavirus yesterday, but for the vigilance of security agents who, acting on the tip-off, prevented an infected person from boarding a flight from Abuja to Port Harcourt. The infected person beat all security measures that were put in place at the Nnamdi-Azikiwe International Airport, Abuja, and was to sneak into Port Harcourt before security agents stopped her. Based on this alarming information, the State Security Council met yesterday and reviewed measures already put in place and decided that there was urgent need to adopt stringent measures to protect those living and doing business in the state from the virus. The Council has therefore taken the following painful decisions. With effect from 6 p.m. on Thursday, March 26, 2020, the Port Harcourt International Airport, Pamawa, will not be open to air traffic. While we may not have the right to stop flights from entering Port Harcourt, we cannot allow anybody coming from the airport to enter our state. We are confident that the Federal Airports Authority of Nigeria FAN and other federal agencies will cooperate with us. All land and sea borders will be closed. Vehicular movements in and out of the state have been banned. In essence, no vehicle will leave Port Harcourt to any other state, and no vehicle will come in from any other state to River State. These measures are to remain in force until further notice. Let me reiterate that the situation we are facing requires drastic measures because coronavirus has ravaged many countries. Security agencies have been empowered to strictly enforce this directive. There will be no room for sacred cows because the virus is no respecter of persons. May I once again call for the support and understanding of everyone living and doing business in River State to help the relevant government agencies implement these measures to check the spread of coronavirus to the state. At this time in our national life, we must shun primordial sentiments and face the reality on ground. I'm confident that God being on our side, the temporary hardship we are facing today will come to an end very soon. Thank you, and God bless.